Hello friends, I am Prof.Pawaskar. Today we are going to study inverter. Basically, inverter is DC to AC converter. That means if you provide the DC input, then you will get AC output at the load. Basically, there are two types of the inverter, single phase and three phase inverters are there. Today we are going to study single phase bridge inverter. Generally, inverter is used for the controlling the speed of the induction motor. We can control the speed of single phase and three phase induction motor by using this inverter. We have used here four IGBTs, Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4. Now we are going to provide supply or pulses at the IG1 and IG2 and for IG2 and IG3 and IG4. Initially, we are going to turn on this IGBT 1, that is Q1, and IGBT 2, that is Q2. Therefore, current will start flowing from this positive, then this Q1, then this load R, then Q2, and again back to this negative point. Current direction is from left to right. We have marked this current flowing from this terminal, A terminal, to B terminal is a positive current, right? Then we will turn on thyristor number Q3 and Q4. Before that, we will observe or we will study waveforms for thyristor number or IGBT Q1 and Q2. Because of this IGBT gate terminal IG1 and IG2, we are providing the pulses at IG1 and IG2 for Q1 and Q2. Therefore, you will get the waveform similar to this one up to this time period T by 2. Then we will turn on this Q3 and Q4. Therefore, current will start flowing from Q3, then from B terminal to A terminal through this load R, then Q4, and again back to this negative. Now you can observe current flowing through the load is from B to A. Initially it was from A to B. Therefore, you will get the waveform, voltage waveform, exactly reverse to this first one up to this T, because we are giving the supply to the gate terminal up to this T. Therefore, you will get the output voltage up to this T. Then again you will trigger, or again you will turn on Q1 and Q2. Therefore, you will get the waveform similar to the first one. Total time period for this waveform is T. Because of thyristor, because of IGBT Q1 and Q2, you will get this kind of the waveform, and because of conduction of this Q3 and Q4, you will get the this kind of the waveform with the magnitude equal to supply voltage VDC, here positive, and this will be negative. So by providing this DC input at the inverter's input side, then you will get the alternating voltage at the load side of the inverter.
Thank you. So guys, stay innovative, stay hungry, subscribe the channel, press the bell icon. I will get back to you very soon with new stuff. Till then, bye-bye.